Welcome back, everybody. In this video, we are going to discuss long pulling. Now, long pulling is a technique used by Signalar. The other videos, not as important, but this one, pay attention. Okay, so a lot of the stuff in this video is going to be taught by comparing to the last video. So we're going to be comparing Ajax requests with long pulling. And the primary difference is the response of the server. So if you remember an Ajax request, you have the client, and it makes a request, and it's like, hey, bro, you got any new data? And the server is like, let me think about it. No, we don't. And then the client is like, okay, do you have any more data? And he's like, no, we don't. And then it's like, oh, do you have any more data? Oh, we actually do. Here, have it. Finally, we get that data. Well, long pulling is going to change that a little bit. Now, instead of giving an instant response with no, it's just going to keep the request until it does have new data. So, hey, server, do you have any new data? Maybe, not really, but we're waiting on it. Oh, yeah, we have new data. We finally just got some. Right, so to put this in real life perspective, imagine you borrow money from someone, and he's real big and scary, right? And he texts you, and he's like, yo, bro, where's my money? You got my money? You have two options. The first thing you can do is say, no, I don't have your money. Sorry. Not a good idea. Or you can just wait. Gotta love those people. And then once you do have the money, you can finally tell him, hey, I got your money. That's basically the difference between Ajax requests and long pulling. Ajax requests just say, no, I don't. Long pulling is going to wait until it does have something to say. So that's why this is kind of waits. So when should you use long pulling? Well, as I already told you, SignalR is automatically going to pick the best way to communicate from the client to the server. So you usually don't have to worry about it. But if you want to specify a specific one you want to use, you can skip a process known as negotiation. Negotiation is a process where the server and the client agree upon the way they're going to communicate, whether it be WebSockets, event source, long pulling, whatever. If you know which one you want to use, you can skip negotiation and save some system resources. Now, usually negotiation is not a huge issue when it comes to system resources. So my suggestion, just let it do its thing. Sounds so dumb. It's not natural once you plan it out. Okay. Now, I wanted to point out, there are some downsides to using long pulling. The first one is it's not a persistent connection. The only thing long pulling does is simulate a persistent connection. But in reality, it's going to be making tons of requests to the server. And servers have the memory of like a baby goldfish. All right, you're gonna have to remind that server every single request who you are. With a persistent connection, the amount of data that gets sent back and forth is drastically lower. The other downside is that it's one way. By this I mean, even though long pulling is cool, there's no real way for the server to do a push. The only thing it can do is make it look like the server is doing a push. By that I mean the server, it can't tell all the clients there's new data once it gets it. There's always a request for data, even though it's behind the scenes. If we had a server push, then we would never have to make requests to the server to ask for new data. Now, you should also know that with long pulling, there can be an occasional timeout. And that's usually not an issue because right after the timeout, there will be a new request sent out by the client. So you usually don't have to worry about that. But just so you know. Alright, so in the next video, we're going to be showing all of this visually, and it's going to be a really good video, so I really recommend you watch it. Thanks, guys, and I'll see you there.